The code inspector. The code inspector offers you the option of analyzing your programs with regard to performance, security, and typical semantic errors. When you analyze your program, you can ask yourself some basic questions. For example, issues related to performance. Are indexes used for database access? Are select statements embedded in loops? You have to take care of these things in your program if you want a better performance. Security. Is data read from a client other than the login client? Is the database table or the where clause dynamically specified in the select statement? Some questions for typical semantic errors are: is the size subRC field checked after each authority check statement? Is a client actually specified for client specified? Are several messages of type E or E messages sent in direct succession? These questions are very important when you analyze your program. Calling the code inspector. If you want to call the code inspector, a useful tool that SAP provides on your programs, you can right click on your program name, then select check, and then select code inspector. The code inspector can help us analyze our program in different ways. For example, it performs performance checks, security checks, syntax check generation, user interfaces, screen checks, and so on. As the result of an inspection, you receive a list of error and warning messages. The I button that belongs to the messages shows a detailed error description as well as improvement suggestions. That I button would be this button here. Whenever you click it, a screen will pop up showing you what you can do in the system to improve that message. Double click on the error text to branch to the corresponding program statement. So you can use the code inspector to analyze your program every time you finish a development. Let's try and analyze a program inside the SAP system using the code inspector. So let's analyze the program using the code inspector. Let's navigate to the object navigator. Inside our object navigator, let's navigate to our package cflight, and let's examine our program cflight report using the code inspector. To do that, we right click on the program, we select check, and we select code inspector. Then SAP instantly shows us a list of results of our program. So for example, for our program, we can see that in this case we have 13 errors, one warning, and zero information messages. So as we can see, the code inspector is divided in performance checks, security checks, syntax check generation, and user interfaces. So let's start with the performance checks. We have one warning. So let's open the small tree here, and let's open this folder also. and let's open this warning. And here we can find the warning. And we have the message, the program C flight report include row 36, column 2, table S flight has no wear condition. If we want to see more information about this warning, we can click on the eye icon. And this pop-up message window is displayed. And here we can read a little bit about the problem is the code inspector analysis of the wear condition for the select. No wear condition is specified. And it gives us a link that we can click. And you can read all this documentation to correct your warning, or you can leave it like that also if you want. It doesn't affect the activation of the program. What about the errors? Let's take a look at the errors. As you can see, the errors are on the syntax check generation. So let's open the folder. Let's open all the way up to the errors. So, for example, we can see the error. So it's telling us that the character string without text element will not be translated, and the character string is airline code. So we can double click if we are not sure about what this error means to navigate to the program to see what line is causing this error. Remember, this error doesn't affect the activation of the program. This is an error for the system, and it's telling me that this airline code is not going to be translated if this program is read in another language. When you use hard code text, the text is not translated, but if you use variables or text elements, then you can configure your subsystem so that it automatically translates to another language. So in this case, all of these titles we write, the system is telling us that they are not going to be translated to another language. But that is not a problem in our case, so we are going to ignore that error and the rest of the errors. All of these errors are related to writing text, as you can see, without using text elements or variables. Since these were just test programs, we use messages just using hard code text. Let's go back. And let's open these two errors. For example, it's telling us to use the addition currency when outputting fields that represent values. So let's double click, and when we output the payment sum, this payment sum could be in dollars, could be in any other currency around the world. So the code inspector is telling us to please specify what currency this value is for. So yes, we can add that, or we can leave it like that. It is better if we add it. And the same error is reported with this, the total booking. It is better if we specify a currency for it. So as you can see, the code inspector is very useful to produce high quality programs. It is always a good programming practice to run the code inspector in all of your programs. You can use transaction SCI, or the graphic to the right, to set up the check individually. To do so, define the following in the transaction SCI. A check variant used to specify how detailed the check is. An object set used to specify which objects, for example, all programs of a package, are to be checked. And finally, an inspection used to specify the previously defined check variant and the previously defined set of objects. After you define the object set, the check variant, and the inspection, you execute the created inspection by pressing the appropriate button, or in this case, the execute button. So let's create an individual check for our C flight program. Inside the SAP system, we navigate to transaction SCI and we hit enter. And then the code inspector initial screen is displayed. In this case, we can create an object set, a check variant, and an inspection. So let's start with the object set. So let's create my object set. And let's click on create. So here a screen is presented with a lot of options. You can specify, for example, a package, and inside the package a function group that you want to be checked, and you specify it here. Or for example, you want some program to be checked, so you specify it here. So every time you want to check that package or that function group or that set of programs, you just have to get into the code inspector transaction SCI and select your object set. You don't have to be selecting it one by one every time. You just load your saved object set. So for example, let's create an object set for our program, C Flight Report program. So we check activate selection and rewrite the program name C Flight Report in the input field. And we save our object set. The systems tell us the object set was saved successfully, so we go back. And now let's create a check variant. So my check variant. And then we click on new. And then here we define the list of checks we want for our object set or for our program. So for example, for our C Flight Report program, we want the general checks to be made, the performance checks, the security checks, and the syntax check generation. We don't want programming conventions, metric, dynamic test, user interfaces, and all of these options to be checked. So we just select that and then we save. And we go back. Once we have the object set and the check variant, we create an inspection. So we specify a name and then we click on create. On the inspection, we select the object set on the object selection screen. So we can click the match code and we select our recently created object set. This is this one, my object set. And we have to select also our check variant. So we click and we can select my check variant. As you can see, SAP provides more variants for you to use. If you want to check the security check all, the security kernel access, and so on. You can choose any of these SAP predefined variants. Let's use our variant for this case. Now we can save our inspection. It was saved, so we can use it many times, just not one time, you know. And now every time we want to check the program, we can just enter the SCI, load our inspection, and then just click on execute. and the inspection is then carried out in our program or on our object set. If we define more than one program, then it is going to be done on all of our programs. So the system tells us the inspection was carried out successfully, and we can go ahead and check the statistics. For example, the error statistics. No error statistics available for this example. Let's take a look at the results of this inspection. So we click on this little icon, results, and it brings us back to the code inspector screen. Remember, when you right click on the program, we ended up on the same screen. And as you know, we already saw these errors. So we know if we navigate to the errors, there are the same errors about the airline code without text elements, and the errors about the currency addition that we were missing. So using the transaction SEI, we can create a lot of inspections, save them and load them, and we can create various object sets and various check variants. So if we are a project manager, for example, and we need to check all of our developers programs, we can assign them all a specific package, and then we can just go ahead and create an object set with that package, and then create a check variant, and then just constantly loading our inspection and checking the programs. You should now be able to explain the purpose of the runtime analysis in the code inspector. List the basic functions of the runtime analysis and the code inspector. Use both tools for the simple analysis of your programs.